پاکستانی عقیدہ پر, ایز اف ہیئر دا پیپل لیونگ اوور ہیئر آر آل آر جاہل. لیٹ می ایکسپلین دا تھنگ, آئی ایم ناٹ ٹاکنگ آف دا امامز اینڈ خطیبز اینڈ نارملی پروفیشنل پریچرز ہو گو آن اینوئل وزٹس, آئی ایم ناٹ ٹاکنگ آف اور دا پیرز, سم موسٹ آف دا پیرز کیرینگ آؤٹ رانگ کائنڈ آف پریکٹسز آن دا نیم آف اسپرچوئلزم, آل دو دے ہیو گیون اے ویری بیڈ نیم ٹو تصوف, مسٹیسزم اینڈ اسپرچوئلزم. دیز آر دا ریزن دیٹ پیپل کین ایزلی انڈرسٹینڈ اینڈ دے آر دیئر مائنڈز آر ریڈی ٹو ایکسپٹ دا رانگ ایلیگیشن ٹو without differentiating between the wrong and right. This is the basic problem. Let me explain, as far as the knowledge, expansion of knowledge and depth of knowledge is concerned, Indo-Pak subcontinent, India and Pakistan particularly, any country has no match with Pakistan and this part of the world, as far as the depth of the classical Islamic knowledge is concerned. The Arab people, they are superior to the people and ulama from here, as far as the language is concerned. They are better in language. No doubt, this is their language. Arabic is their language. They have to be. But as far as the analytical knowledge is concerned, derivative knowledge is concerned, deductive knowledge is concerned, exegetical knowledge is concerned, classical knowledge is concerned, traditional knowledge, conventional knowledge, and moreover the rational knowledge, logical knowledge of Quran, of tafsir, of hadith, of usul, of fiqh, each and everything, the non-Arabs were never behind the Arabs, rather their contribution is much, much, much higher and deeper than the Arab world in Islamism. None of the six Aima of Hadith of Siyasita is from Arab world. None of the six Ashabu Sita, Ashabu Siya is Arab. Imam Bukhari is not Arab. He belongs to Central Asia. Bukhara from Uzbekistan. He belongs to Central Asia. Imam Muslim. He belongs to Central Asian states near Iran. Imam Tirmizi belongs to Central Asian states near Iran. Imam Abu Dawud were not an Arab, belonged to these states. And Imam Nasai and Imam Ibn Majah, all these six Ashabu Sitta were non-Arabs. I'm just giving you the thing which I am telling you now. Same has been existing throughout the history, every century of Islamic history. Come to the four Imams of Fiqh, only one out of the four is an Arab. And there is Imam Malik, who belonged to Medina. Three are non-Arabs. And you know Imam Abu Hanifa, he was unanimously considered and regarded as Al-Imam Al-Azam by other Imams of Fiqh. Imam Shafi'i and other Imams used to say him, he is Al-Imam Al-Azam. So he was from non-Arab world, belonged to Kufa. Imam Shafi'i was from Egypt. Egypt is in Africa, African subcontinent, non-Arab world. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal was from Baghdad. Baghdad was a province of Iran. They, at a very later stage, ultimately after the conquest, these countries became the part of Arab world. After expansion. When Islamic State went on expanding and the new lands and new all these were, even the Syria, it became a part of Arab world. Originally it was not Arab. Iraq originally was not Arab. Syria originally was not Arab. Urdan originally was not Arab. Palestine originally was not Arab. Egypt I have explained. All these countries joined the Arab world because of conquest and Islamic expansion. They became the part and parcel of the world, Islamic world. So they adopted the language of Arabic at a later stage. So this is the basic thing to be considered. And the same way as you go on with other Aima of Hadith, Imam Behaki and Imam Tabarani, and you go on Imam Bazar and of But you will see hundreds of Imams of Hadith and even Sahibul Mishkat, Imam Khatib Tabrizi. Hundreds of Imams of Hadith and Imams of Fiqh and their students, they belong to non-Arab world. That's why Holy Prophet ﷺ stated, La fadla li Arabiyyin ala ajamiyyin. This was one of the reasons which only Prophet's eyes could see and nobody else could see. He could see lot many things when he was saying these words. One was the negation of the tribal superiority, the wrong concept of tribal superiority. One reason was the negation of this idea. But at the other hand, he was saying that there is no superiority available to any Arab over non-Arab and non-Arab. This depends upon what service do you render to Islam. So, first of all, you should remove. This is your primary duty when you go back. You have to fight against this wrong complex of inferiority. And one reason which I can understand why this complex was spread. Why was this complex put in the minds of the younger generation, you people? The reason is that the people belonging to this part of the world, they are emotional. The Pakistani people, the Bangladeshi, the Indian, this part of the world is emotional, sentimental, temperamentally. Temperament-wise, this part of the world, people belong to here, they are emotional, sentimental. As compared to the Western world and other world. Since these are emotional and sentimental people, so they would be emotional. If they go to bad side, they would be emotional to go to good side. So they are emotional in their attachment with Islam, attachment with Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, love with Holy Prophet, and they practice whenever they start practicing and celebrating their love to Holy Prophet, they celebrate it in a very emotional and very cordial and very sentimental way, which creates a quite good sense of attachment to the people. It gives a good message.